Hello.
Oh, you're there.
What? Yes.
This is Robin. I'm calling from San Francisco.
Hey, Robin. How are you?
Good. Finding enough things to do to keep yourself awake. You having enough customers?
Yeah. Look at these guys back here. You'll see them in a second. There's a little delay. They're still packing away.
Oh, good.
I know. I'm gonna take a little walk outside.
You're going outside?
Yeah, I need to either wake up or take a nap. I might fall asleep in a snowdrift.
Are you taking the camera, your camera with you, or no?
No, I can't. The camera's fixed.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Well, that's okay, because I'm outside, too, but I'm sure it's not. Yeah, how much snow do you have?
We've got, like, 10 inches.
Oh, wow.
I know. It's not a good start to the... Not a good start to the winter.
Yeah. Well, listen, I'm wondering if you can help me.
Sure.
This is I'm a native of Schoharie County.
Oh, wow. Hey,
neighbor. Yeah. And on a very cold, snowy night in February, almost 16 years ago, the last night I spent in Schoharie County before I moved to California,
yeah.
I spent in Sharon Springs.
Aww.
With a lovely, wonderful friend of mine, and he invited me to his home. We watched on video, we watched Sunset Boulevard, which totally prepared me for California. Do you know that movie?
Yeah.
So anyway... Since I came out here, I lost his contact information. He didn't have email yet. His partner had email, and then he was moving around, and I lost touch with him. And I'm wondering if he's still around, because a couple of years ago, I spent a few weeks volunteering with the flood relief after Irene.
Yeah.
And Sharon Springs was having its festival.
Yeah.
So I came up, and there was a man whose name was something like Audacious or something like that. He was selling chocolate.
Ostentatious, yeah.
Ostentatious, right. Yeah. He was a kick in the pants. And I mentioned my friend's name, and he said he was still around. I went down to the house where he lived. I couldn't raise a soul, so I stopped by many times. So I'm wondering, is he still around, and would you know him? Because, like, people in Sharon Springs, everybody knows everybody,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, what's his name?
His name is Lalo.
Lalo.
Padilla.
Lalo what?
Padilla. I think P-A-D-I-L-L-A.
Let me ask you. Ask
you back. Adorable little Mexican man.
Do you know anybody named Lalo Padilla? A Sharon Springs person, Lalo Padilla? You do? A little guy? Brent knows him. Not very well, but knows of him, so he's still around.
Oh. But he doesn't know him personally?
No, he just knows who he is and has met him before.
Oh, crap.
Why, you want to get in touch with him?
I'd love to get back in touch with him, that's the thing.
Well, here, do me a favor. Starting, like, after the new year, because... send us an email, but it'll get lost in the crush now. But send us an email after the new year. Just send an email to beekman1802@beekman1802.com.
Okay. Is that on your website? Because I'm outside because I didn't want to wake up the family.
Yeah, you just go to beekman1802 and hit the contact button, and it'll get to us.
1802@1802.com.
So after the first of the year, send us an email and say you're trying to find them. And Brent said he knows him, and we'll track him down.
That would be so wonderful. He lives on the street that comes up right across from the American Hotel.
Oh, is it Union?
Hmm?
Union Street?
I think so. That could be it. It goes down a hill, and it's back, you know, it's perpendicular to the main drag there.
Oh, okay. I don't know the name.
Right. That would be... If you could help me with that would be so fabulous.
We will certainly do that. Email us right after the first of the year.
Okay, great. great. I would appreciate that so much because he was just a real dear, and you would like him too.
I can't wait to meet him.
Okay. Well, hey, the other thing is I'll be moving back in sometime in this winter. So I'll stop by and buy something then. Or you gonna close for a while?
No, we're the only full time year round business in Sharon Springs.
Oh great. Well, I wish you all kinds of success with what you're doing. My daughter and I enjoyed your television show. From time to time we go look at it and it's like, Oh, the country. So San Francisco's a lovely town, but time to come home.
Well, we'll see you when you get back then.
Okay, thanks, and have a very Merry Christmas, a wonderful New Year, and keep doing all the wonderful things you're doing. It's nice to have Sharon Springs and someplace from Sperry County on the map.
Oh, it is great. Thank you. Thank you so much. Talk to you soon.
Okay, many blessings to you. Bye-bye.
Bye. Okay, guys, well, I made it to 3:51, which I'm going to call 4 o'clock. And I'm just going to take a short break to maybe lay down, but it's just going to be short. So I'll be back. I'm going to leave the doors open, and you can say hi to everybody there. If you want to call, they'll answer the phone.
Beekman 1802.
Thank you.
Beekman Team Members. Hi, Lorraine. How are you? Yeah, we're all still packing orders here. What are you doing up so late? Oh, you are? Well, I'm glad we could keep you company tonight.
The 9487, you definitely have a shipping.
Yes?
I'm going to crumple it up.
Oh, fantastic. This is so much a thing that's international.
Right. What is this, a jumper?
Yeah. It's a kid,
Where does this go? Where do you just make it up?
No, you must have an innocent face. Oh, and a Catholic schoolgirl face. Well, I appreciate you spending some time with us tonight, and thank you for calling in. Are you watching on YouTube as well? All right, well, it's a little bit of a delay, but I'm waiting for you right now. All right, so, well, in a couple of seconds, you'll see me waving to you. You too. Are you coming to pick up the Sharon Springs? Where are you at? Iowa. Yeah, we're shipping out all night tonight and all day tomorrow, so it should go out tomorrow. Yeah, he's on a little break right now. Yeah. Well, thank you, and thank you for thinking of us for your gift. Well, we appreciate it, and we have to see you there in the Sharon Springs one day. Oh, well, we look forward to it. We'll leave the light on for you. All right, take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Watching you live now. You guys are great.
Aww.
We should hold that invoice up. Hi, Karen McKellen. McClellan, if you're still watching, we're sending out your order right now. Thank you.
Thank you. gone by?
Close to perfect. Well, I'm sure you're raising a good son. Yes, well, I appreciate that. I truly appreciate that. And if you look at your YouTube in the next few seconds, you'll see me waving at you. We're on a little bit of a delay, like a couple minute delay. Yeah, so you'll see me waving to you in just a minute. No, he's taking a little break. Oh, you know what? You probably need to refresh. Yeah, because he left maybe 10 minutes ago. That was a hat. Yeah, that was a hat. A local farmer, she raises the sheep and shears them, and then uses the wool to make those hats, and she's a bit of fabric.
Yes.
Oh, thank you. Well, we're trying hard, and you know, thank you. Well, we like that. I mean, we like to share what we're learning, and you know, we want. Thank you. We were too. Well, we appreciate that you cheered us on. We're doing pretty good. I mean, we'll be working all day tomorrow and all night tonight, and everybody wave to the woman in Nebraska. You'll see everybody waving. And, oh, I thought you said Nebraska. I'm sorry. See, you see, I'm tired, so I thought you said Nebraska. your neighbor now is even closer to the time.
Don't worry about it.
This is great. Okay. Celebration. And then, you may make you to meet your moms. I bet you do. Well, you're at Syracuse, it's not that far, so we expect to see you there sometime.
No.
Oh, yeah, well, Memorial Day weekend is our garden party festival.
There.
Yep.
Are you good?
So, oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's not that far away. It's like an hour. Saturday and Sunday.
They're out in the on the floor.
Yeah, did you read? Because
if
you hover over the screen, yeah, she will tell you to reset. Because I think what happened is that with every 4 hours we have to generate a new link.
Okay.
And you probably didn't generate the new, you didn't click on the new link yet. So it'll just go back. I'm going to hand the phone over to Brian and he can tell you how to reset it, okay? Right. You too, and Merry Christmas. All right, here's Ryan.
Huh? 15 degrees warm. Out there or here? Yeah.
Josh. Yeah.
Oh.
Thank you.
Yeah. Who is it?
Sylvia again.
Hi, Sylvia.
Here, try a little more. also not after the day of the
If you're going to get two cheesecake boxes. Coming your way.
It's the first yard.
That's weird.
I'm just pretty happy that my first yard is
This is when you start picking up your second wind. It's like the 3 o'clock hour.
I needed my second wind just to get back here.
This one?
Yeah, it's light stuff on top of that, though, so you can just like lift up the handle and let go. Thank you. I'm gonna do this one first, just so I can do those things.
That's when we can sit down.
Give me that.
for the Hilton Hospital.
I don't put down a ton of bean sheets. Remember that I asked everything for gift wrap?
Yeah. Well, that's kind of handy when we have our gift wrap.
Thank you.
is really, really perishable?
Two cheesecakes. I mean, I guess the fruit cakes are offset to make it mildly crunchy.
Serious pile lying around, like a stuff that is delayed to go out and see.
There is one that's, that the front says must ship on Tuesday ASAP.
Thank you. I like that. That
he said, how many? 378 can we help that do?
Yeah. That's more than we have.
Hear what you just said.
Just imagine where we'd be if
we were here.
We'd all come in the morning, there would be the.
I mean, we've probably gotten maybe done 300, or at least we've only gotten 300.
Yeah. I mean, we've put an entire day's shift.
Do I go or do I stay?
We'll meet you tomorrow.
What?
Are you just sitting there with a little bit?
Yeah, maybe find that in.
Oh, yeah, yeah, over there, because there's no roof. It would be true. Yeah. You're like, go! And it's just like,
and then you see blood all over.
Oh, yeah.
What?
The topic of zombie apocalypse.
I always think of that elevator in the zombie apocalypse. Whenever I'm in it, I just imagine them crawling over the top and like falling down on top of me. Alright, who was... Oh, people haven't been damaging the lot on the Russian lot. I don't know. They should.
Let's see that.
Well, I like to actually... I put two sheets of little bubble around the lot and keep it scratching. That snuggles in place.
Or just wrap a stand and dunnage. So you're not using the expensive button.
That's true.
Oh.
Just tuck it in.
Yeah. Oh.
Sleepy.
Chuckle. I have a chuckle.
Really, cobalt skill? You can't drive down the road.
Mister? She let you that last one.
Josh could get back here soon. Morning. Kitchen. I went out and got firewood, brought it into the kitchen. 3 hours later, the snow was still on the firewood. That's how cold it is in our house.
My mom brings me even at around 55 during the day. That's toasty. So during the day, you're awake, so you know better to put a sweatshirt on, damn it.
That sounds like your mom.
Mom, my feet are really cold. Do you have socks on?
Yeah.
Full socks on?
Yeah, two pairs on.
Do you have shoes on? No. Well, what's the damn shoes? And that would always come down to, do you want to go to Disney this year?
Yeah.
Well, what, your shoes?
She really likes that, Mr. Fish.
Oh, yeah, she knew exactly. Officially talking for the boxes.
And Chloe's here right now too, right?
Yeah.
So Chloe, Sarah, and Donna will do cheats. At least now when you're in the army, they don't make you run into combat. It's good.
We have like there's stages of training. There will be PT in boots. PT will be done actually training year. They were just sending too many guys to the hospital with like this frank stress fractures. My mom spent 6 out of 14 weeks with CS on crutches because it's 10 minutes.
Oh, really?
guys in your class helping her in and out of the pool.
So we won't get the cheese and carrots wrapped in until early afternoon.
Thank you. story was pretty good. You know, but, yeah, I've been doing this for a while. It's only for Christmas, I think, but still, it really adds like, it's like 3 hours. It
really shouldn't have to.
Yeah, what they are where you should be, they. They already don't have to pick up the packages.
Yeah. I think he wasn't making a lot of time. Good.
What? Oh, should that be?
Going on last week.
Do we know where the clear bags are?
Upstairs.
Not the answer that I wanted.
What's another number?
It isn't downstairs.
You're going to need extra. Watts, or you can push the gas pedals on the caddy.
Not so start working. School bus full of children. They probably all would have suffocated by now.
See you in a few hours.
Get your dad up.
He's probably up on
the way. Have your mom drop him off on the way.
He won't want to be up there. His mom's been up for 40 minutes already.
Oh, yeah.
Right. I'll see you guys.
Downstairs,
I'd say look under the stairs or around the stairs would be my best guess. All right. See you soon, guys. Thank you.
Good job. Do you want to print out any new orders that are coming in?
Yeah, all right. So, Billy, did you print out those ones for the last night?
Yeah, did you print them? Can you just track it and see if it's required?
Yes, I'm sorry, I'm too tired. There's a label on the top. Okay.
Yeah, so that's why I'm going to show you this.
This is the same. It looks part of the BVC. Great. We're going to sort this in order. There's only four local. Thank you.
To have the post office send another truck this morning.
Yeah, pretty sure that's already been arranged.
How that camera is doing.
truck also, but I don't think they actually will come the same day. You just get to do it when you call.
Maria or Pete or somebody has the UPS driver's number.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
I think we have it on the wall here.
Yeah. You could probably call her in the morning, but she can probably arrange for it. Yeah.
Yeah.
There are people.
Right.
Before you head out, do you want me to know the other?
No, I just wanted to.
Oh, you're not leaving.
Stay active.
Yeah.
When it's really cold like this, it's just.
Well, car.
Really?
Yeah.
Come on. It's a new car.
You know, we started. 45 days after being abandoned in the driveway. She limped home on a broken wheel and just kind of ran out of gas in the driveway. I gave her a full tank of gas and she cranked right up.
Here's a nice.
It's a large block and a medium block.
Oh. Well, I didn't expect it to twist so much.
I still got the torque, I guess. Did you print those out?
Had you ordered more of the thank you cards?
The
No, the Josh and Brent. Okay, thank you. Yeah, we're out. I think they come from Trampoline. Less. Trash out
there. Yeah. Is Eugene coming in? I thought he was.
Yeah, but when did they come from? Where?
I'm not usually.
He said he's coming in. Rosemary is making homemade pizza for lunch.
I mean, you said these piles aren't really big enough for a bag, so I'm just going to leave them. If I need more.
Today, you know?
Right. Today. I'm putting this just over there. These are the local, these are the, like, three locals and two. There's a ton of homes. stacks of them missing. Yeah, it might have happened at some point to say there were so many things flying around. Probably got. Alright, I'm gonna head out soon. This looks like a wholesale heat had started. Back, I'm going to try to get the rest of the wholesales out because they're not that broke.
This one big one.
Found it. This has been hanging overhead all night. Okay. So actually, can I just put this on the stack that you're working on? Because all this stuff has to happen. It all has special instructions just to modify. So actually, this one specifically says we got shipped until December 18th. But most of them just say ship the week of the 26th. I guess I should put this in a little picture. invoice in a sign-in sheet that says do not move? I'm going to listen to it, but it's a phone order with the sign-in, but it's like do not move. A small rat go pop.
Like that?
Yes, cut that.
Ah. That's what Chloe was looking for.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Ain't Alan Beck.
Alan Beck.
Ah.
Every single week I see it in here. Every single week I listen to the note on it. It says,
I heard you around every time you asked me. It was.
I'm like, I guess I'm not going to move it this week. That's awesome. All right, should I leave this on the desk or leave it in the sign-in sheet?
I mean,
I guess someone really wants it in there. So was today 12/16? Or was that yesterday? Which is today.
Can you imagine if you did that to Amazon? No, I don't. Shit, January 2014.
It's funny though. It's really it's just the certain orders that take so much time. Most of them just go right out.
Yeah, really, they were sold those samplers.
Which samplers?
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah,
that's
No, I think probably what we'll have to do is call the people who ordered the sampler and substitute a pack of coffee instead. Yeah. Is she bringing more cheesecake? It's from the 8th. It doesn't have a note on the weight.
Oh, sorry, what?
Like this order is from the 8th. It doesn't have a note on here.
It was in the file. I don't know if that was your file. Maybe someone called it anywhere, but of course, no one would write on it. It was in there, people wanted to wait for Christmas.
Just dropped off that.
Do you have water coming? You do? She was here, what, Friday?
Nick, can you peek in there? Oh, you're in there.
What am I peeking in?
Yeah, not even looking at any new orders. I'm holding on one. Plus, I've got 5 orders here. There are 4 and 3.
Is there a
Alright. Oh no! So this entire time I've been looking for my phone charger, I always keep it in my right pocket, it was in my left pocket.
Left out in the car?
Let's ask for 20.
Call Josh on my, you know my cell phone?
Yeah.
Hey, Nick, yeah. There was a wholesale order in this chat. 60 onion jam, 60 tomato jam, or real tomato jam.
That was one of the big fun.
Okay, are you ready?
Yeah.
917-576-4848. Good morning, everybody. There are 70 people online watching. Anybody there? If you're there, all right. If you're there, shout out.
Have a good morning.
Is it morning? Is there sun coming up? All right. If somebody's there, good. Hello?
Is this Josh?
Oh, yes, it's Josh. Who's this?
This is Paula from Virginia. How are you?
Well, Paula, let me...
Are you guys surviving?
We're surviving. Brent, did you want to wave?
Good morning.
I got up early for a run.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I did, too.
Yeah, right. Hey, I have a great idea for you guys to do next year.
What?
You need to do, like, The Apprentice. You need to have one lucky person. Oh, there you are. There's your cute face. You need to have one lucky person come, and it could be, like, a show, and they get to be the apprentice and help you out.
That would be awesome, so they can come and stay up all night.
Exactly.
And I can go home and sleep.
But I think you should pick me since it was my idea.
Oh, I don't think you want this job. Okay, I'll pick you.
Okay, thank you.
How's that?
All right.
You got up early to go for a jog?
Yeah, I got up at 4:30. Well,
how cold is it where you are?
It's about 34. Not too bad.
That's pretty bad.
Well, not compared to you.
That's true, yeah. You know, I didn't even look. I was just in the truck a few minutes ago, but on the way up, it was -8.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God, it's terrible. But the Mercantile is really warm, so I'm happy to be back.
Exactly. I'm worried about Brent.
He's gonna go freshen up in a second. And when the second crew comes in the morning, or the night crew is just wrapping up.
Oh, good.
And then
I worry about him. He works so hard.
Yeah, I know. He overworks. He never does what I say, either.
I mean, you both work really hard, but he's crazy.
Yeah. What are you implying there?
What's that?
What are you implying there?
No, just that he's so, I mean, he is such a driven person, and, I mean, you seem to know that you need to take a break. Brent doesn't ever seem like he needs to take a break. I don't know.
Did you hear that? Brent, No, he'll go home shortly.
Okay, good. All right, well, I will let you go. I just thought I'd say hello, and this is a cute idea. You guys are adorable.
Well, thank you. There'll be more Sharon Springs folks coming by today at some point, so you have to stay tuned in.
I'll check in here and there, but I do have to go do things.
Really,
I wish I could just stay and watch you guys all day, but...
All right. Thank you so much. Have a good jog. Have a good day.
Merry Christmas.
All right. You too. Merry Christmas.
Bye-bye.
All right. I have a very serious request now. I mean, the Charo request is serious, too, but this is really serious. If there's anybody in Sharon Springs that's awake and out or getting ready to go out, I need a cup of tea with honey like you wouldn't believe. And if it, maybe somebody's at Stewart's right now or watching on their phone or something, if you're at Stewart's up on the corner, just black tea, Earl Grey, breakfast tea with honey. You can see my throat's a little shot. Oh, that's okay. This is a private caller. You're fancy. Hello.
Good morning.
Hi, who's this?
This is Suzanne Koba.
Hi, Suzanne. Did you just get
Hi.
Up?
Hi.
Did you just wake up?
No, I've been sitting here since 4 o'clock waiting to talk to someone.
Oh, my goodness. Did no one answer the phone before that?
I'm glad that you are refreshed.
Yeah, well, relatively.
Relatively? Okay. You're probably more refreshed than I am.
Why? Did you not sleep well last night?
Oh, I don't sleep that good ever.
Oh, yeah, it gets that way. I'm that way now, too.
Oh, it must be the age thing.
I think it is. Brent will be there soon.
Pardon?
Brent will be there soon.
Not soon enough. He needs to slow down.
You think so?
I think so. I have a question about one of the products.
Okay.
The thing that drips the honey?
Yes.
Now, if I do, I'm assuming we can use that in the house.
Yes. The tray on the bottom.
Yeah. I mean, I was at the wedding, so I know how it all works.
Yeah,
I was just wondering, if I do it in the house, is there a certain temperature before that honey drips down, or do we have to heat it up, or what?
No, it should be at room temperature. Of course, this time of year, you know, the house might be cooler. It might not be as good. But it should be pretty liquefied once the honey is thawed.
Oh, okay.
It should drip pretty well. If not, I think that's a good question. What would you do if you were inside and the house was too cold?
Well, I was even thinking I could put it out in our family room because we always have bees in there anyhow, and that way they'll go there.
That's a good idea. It's a bee trap.
That way they won't sting the grandkids like they just did the other day.
Oh, my gosh. That's true. Maybe the saying's true. You catch more bees with honey than without honey.
Oh, boy, that's a loaded one. I could really... and also another quick observation.
Yeah.
I was watching The Amazing Race the other day. Did you guys know, you probably do know, that the twins are going to be in an Amazing Race for people who've already been on?
Yeah, the All-Stars, the Amazing Race All-Stars.
Yes, that's it, yes.
I know. Isn't that great? Did you get...
Yes.
You got to meet the twins, right?
Yes. Yes,
yeah.
We did.
The twinnies came to the wedding for everybody at home. Twinnies came to the wedding, and, don't you think that they got a kind of a bad edit on TV?
Pardon? I didn't get that. I was trying to talk to Bob.
Oh, so don't you think the twinnies got kind of an evil edit on the Amazing Race?
Yes.
Yeah, so they were really lovely in person, right?
Yes, they were. They were nothing like they appeared on the TV show.
Right. So... I saw on the commercial too. They said, looks like they got a second chance. I don't know if anybody else from our season did. But,
it didn't look like it.
No, it didn't look like it. But
no.
Twinnies all the way.
You guys someone had made a statement at one time that when you watch these reality shows, they're a reality that not everything is what appears to be.
That is very, very true. I mean,
so
I always.
I'm hoping they'll give them a better perspective on this show.
Me too. Of course, you know, once you've been on a reality show too, you sort of understand what you should and shouldn't do.
So, oh, that's true. That's true.
So So we'll.
But the wedding video of the wedding was very nice. I did watch that.
Oh, good. I'm glad you liked it.
I saw my skirt a couple times.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, well, I had the long skirt with the blue with the flowers on it, and yeah. My cane, you know, so
yeah,
I was always.
It was beautiful. Yeah, yeah. You got this. You would stand out with that skirt. That was good.
I know. I probably should have wore something else.
Oh no!
But it was a very nice day. It was very nice. We loved every part of it.
Thank
and
you.
We were so honored to be included in that day.
Oh well, thank you. It was a fun day, and we're so glad that so many of our friends got to a chance to come and celebrate with us. That was more important to us than the wedding.
Well, I appreciate that comment too. I mean, you know, we've been coming, like I say, from Ohio, and I don't like to fly, so we end up driving all the way, kind of like your mom and dad. And
yeah.
It's not a hop, skip, and a jump for us. It's a little bit longer.
I know it was, and it was sort of kind of almost last minute. So that was
yes.
We appreciate it.
Yes, I would have done anything.
Oh, you're so sweet. All right, well, I better take some other calls here.
You have a good day. I hope it all goes well. Like the previous caller, Brent is working his little butt off the back there. He's the only one I see that's really doing everything all the time. And Ander is being a perfect dog. He just walks around and doesn't bark.
And I know, isn't it something? She's taking a little break. She went home for a minute too, so.
Oh, okay. That's why I can't see her lately. Okay.
Yeah.
You have a good one. Thank you so much for taking my call.
All right.
And we love you guys. We'll see you in the Garden Fest.
Love you too. See you soon.
Mm-hmm. Bye-bye.
Bye. All right. Anybody out there? Anybody with T from Stewart's? Bye. Okay. Part of the night shift is leaving. Bye, Nick. Hi there. Okay.
Hello. Good morning from Michigan. My name is Kim, and this is my 9-year-old son, David.
Hey, Kim and David. How are you?
We are awesome. This is Josh.
Hi, Josh.
Hey, David. What's going on?
Not much.
Just getting ready for school, and Josh, David won't eat his breakfast. Help me, Josh.
David, why aren't you eating your breakfast?
Well, hey, I noticed you guys have been on all night. Are you still awake?
I'm still awake. I gotta admit, I snuck away and took a 2-hour nap, but Brent's been awake the whole time. Hey, Brent, say hi. This is David. David is not eating his breakfast this morning.
David is the most important meal of the day. And you know, I'm a doctor. I know these things.
He's a doctor. He knows it.
Oh,
yeah.
How's everything going on the farm?
Everything's good. It's super, super cold here.
Hey, how's that llama drama going on?
Oh, that llama. I don't know. I guess she's all right. I don't even talk to Focus Bot anymore. She's never liked me.
Hey, another question about cheese. Yeah, how long does it take to make it? When you basically make the cheese, when you basically milk the goats and start making the cheese process, how long does it take to make the cheese part of it?
Okay, so when you milk the goats 2 times a day, and then the milk goes into a cooler, and a truck comes usually that day or the next day, depending how full the tank is. And then the truck goes to the cheese place, and then it all goes into a big tank at the cheese place, and they add the cultures and the rennet, and then it separates. You know the old curds and whey? Have you ever heard of that?
Yeah, I've heard of that.
Okay, so the milk is then separated into curds and whey, and then that's all done in one day, and then the curds are packed into baskets, like the size of a cheese wheel. They put the curds in the baskets. They're like wet. They're almost like, what are they like? They're like wet white jello, if that makes any sense.
Yum.
I know. And then they go into these baskets that have little holes in them so the water comes out. And then they drain out, and then they sit in the cave, the cheese cave, which isn't really a cave. It's a cooler. And it's a big walk-in huge cooler that's kept at 55 degrees. and then they stay in there for 3 months.
Wow, I can't believe that.
I know. Have you tried it? Have you had the black cheese?
I've had it. I like it.
Yeah. And then we put the black ash rind on it, and that makes a rind on it, so it's pretty and it ages well.
Speaking of the cheese, do you have any left?
The cheese, we do have some left. So there's usually about 100 to 200 wheels every week that are made, and then. Think about it. Remember how I said it takes 90 days for it to age?
So, how's Farmer John doing?
He's doing good. I'm hoping he stops by this morning. He said he was going to come by sometime between 8 and 10.
Oh, cool. I'd be happy with the way I could record this for today.
Have you had any new goats yet? Like any baby goats?
Oh, we have a ton of baby goats. Every spring we have baby goats. So right now all the mom goats are pregnant, and then we start having baby goats in like right around Valentine's Day they start coming. And then you have to watch the Facebook page because we always post pictures of every new baby goat.
Okay, thank you so much, Josh. You guys have a good day and stay warm.
Hey, did you finish your breakfast?
Not yet. He's been talking to you, but I'm gonna have him take a couple more bites.
All right, I want picture on Facebook of that empty bowl.
Oh, you got it. You better get busy. Hey!
Thanks, Josh!
I'm going to put an order through for cheese. Thank you so much. You have a great day and happy holidays.
Thank you. You too.
Thank you, hon. Bye-bye.
All right, everybody. I'm going to post something on Facebook. I'll be right back. Good morning.
Morning.
Hi, who's this?
This is Marcia from Michigan.
Oh, hey, Marcia from Michigan. Good. What are you doing up? Well, it's not that early. It's almost 7 now.
I just took my dog out.
Is it cold? Is it cold there as it is here?
Oh, yeah. It's so cold. The storm door almost froze shut.
Oh, my goodness. Do you know what today is?
No.
Today is the very last day that people west of the Mississippi can place their order at the Mercantile.
I had placed my order on Black Friday, and everything's all sitting here ready to go to the people.
Oh, gosh, you do everything ahead of time. That's perfect.
Yeah, I make lists like Brent.
Oh, you make lists?
Mm-hmm.
I don't make lists.
I never did, but when I moved, I had to, so.
Yeah. What are you going to do today?
I'm going to sit and watch you guys.
Oh, wow. That's going to be an exciting day.
Yeah, sit here with my coffee and a tart cherry and almond toast.
Oh, you got tart cherry and almond jam on the toast?
Yes.
That's awesome. What else? What did you get for on Black Friday? What did you buy?
I bought the black onion jam, and I bought the some honey, and the midnight jam.
Oh yeah, you know the midnight jam, tart cherry jam is probably my favorite. Don't tell anyone, but the midnight jam is the best seller. People go after that midnight jam like it was a drug.
Yeah, what I like about your jams is they're not that sweet.
Right,
we've got the natural flavor.
Right, we put the first of all, we used real fruit, which most people don't do, and it's hard to find black currants. You know, we grow most of the black currants ourselves.
Yeah, and I love black currants, so it's kind of hard to find good black currant jam around here.
Yeah, not many people make it or grow it anymore, so it's tough.
Now, I've got a question though.
Uh-huh.
I was watching the video from when you guys did the cooking demonstration. I think it was Nordstrom's.
Bloomingdale's.
A fashion night out.
Bloomingdale's,
okay. And you made a tart out of the black jam.
Yeah.
The onion jam.
Yep.
What did you set the temperature at in the... on the oven.
See, it was.
Do you remember?
I'm trying to remember. It was It was the crust. I remember, and it was a fold. So it was almost like a turnover, a tiny little turnover, right?
Right.
Yeah. So it was a tiny little turnover with the black onion jam and a little cheese, I think, inside.
Yeah.
I think it. Let's see. Well, I don't remember exactly, but that would do well in a anywhere from a 375 to a 425. I'd probably do 400.
Okay. I'm giving a party after New Year's, and I want to include that as one of the hors d'oeuvres.
Oh, that is a fun one. It's a good finger food.
Yeah, I want to introduce everybody to the black onion jam, so.
Well, be careful. Once you do, they're all gonna make you buy it every Christmas forever and ever.
Well, that's okay, because I'm always telling people to go to your website.
Oh, thank you very much. Did you like all the Christmas stuff this year?
Oh, yeah, especially the vintage.
Oh, great. I'm going to tell Jody. So, you know, Jody is the girl that finds all the vintage.
Because they were really, because I remember some of the stuff that my parents had.
Right. Like, she has a lot of the great salt and pepper shakers and all the table stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, she's great. She called in last night.
Yeah, I heard her.
Oh, good. Yeah, she is terrific. All right, well, I'll let you go on your day.
Tell Brent not to work too hard.
I won't. He said he's going to go home as soon as the morning crew gets here.
Okay, we'll talk to you later, Josh.
All right. Have a good day.
All right, bye-bye.
All right, how's everybody going? Let's see, we got some questions here. What's our biggest... biggest seller this holiday season is there anything we've been surprised about being more popular than you expected? Well, I'm going to show you our biggest seller, just a second. All right, this is our biggest seller. This every Christmas season since we started the business, this is our biggest seller. This is the year in the country. You'll see it's a gift box like that, right? And on the inside, you've got 12 soaps. Eat one for each scent. You know, each of our soaps is seasonally scented, so January through December. So you have one of each month. And then underneath the soap, once you lift it up, it's like a little candy box. And what kind of soap it is underneath it. So, you know, here's January, and then it describes, you know, the January scent is like snow and pine and a winter day, and then this one is June, and the June scent is mock orange. You see how it says right underneath there? So this is our biggest seller. It's always been our biggest seller, and it still was again this year. And then you asked, was there anything that surprised us about being more popular than we expected? Well, let's see. The fireplace, the poke and blow fireplace tool that people saw earlier, the tool that our blacksmith makes, it's hollow, and so it's a poker for the fireplace, but then you can blow in it and fan the embers. So that was more popular. And then, oh my gosh, the runaway bestseller was the iron cup. We don't have one out, do we? This was the runaway bestseller. This, the iron cup, made by not the blacksmith we usually work with, a new blacksmith called, her name is Ellen Durkin. Ellen Durkin. Ellen Durkin, one of the only female blacksmiths in the U.S. Isn't that amazing? And it's so great, and you can, to make it bigger, you can just pull on the edges and bend it out to fit your wrist. It's so pretty, and it's just like, is that focus on there? So it's like iron lace is what we call it. And this we just have not, I don't even know. She just delivered like 80 today. And I think we only ordered maybe 10 in the beginning because we didn't know how well they would sell. And now we just can't keep them in. And she can't make them fast enough. So, again, if you're west of the Mississippi today, this is your last day to order. Go to shop.beekman1802.com. Get your order in. These guys, did they catch up overnight, Brent?
We're not quite out of it. We're getting there.
Not quite cut up, but they're getting there. So if you want your order by Christmas and you're west of the Mississippi, order it today. If you're east of the Mississippi, order it today. Don't wait, because tomorrow's the last day for anybody east of the Mississippi. And then after that, no guarantees. We can't guarantee it's going to get there. All right, we're going to take a new call. Hey there, it's Josh. Who's this?
Hi, this is Kyle from Elmira, New York.
Wait, did you say Kyle or who?
Cara.
Oh, Cara. Hey, Cara. Did you call last night?
I did not.
No, you didn't. Oh, we had another Cara last night. How's it going? Good morning.
Good morning.
What you doing today?
I'm getting ready to go to work.
Oh, really?
Unfortunately, I wish I could stay home and watch the channel all day, but...
Oh, that's right. I wish I were getting ready to go home.
I wanted to tell you, I was there for the Harvest Festival, and I brought my puppy.
Uh-huh.
And you held him, and his name was Otis, and he was just a little shit then, and now he is 5 months and almost over 50 pounds.
Oh, my gosh, I can't wait to see him. Are you going to bring him back?
Oh, yeah, we'll be back this year, or next year. And my mom had gotten some of your soap for Christmas the previous year, and I really wanted to try it, so she gave me a little... just one of the samples, you know, and it was wrapped up in the brown paper and it had the rope around it, and it was so nice. And I woke up one morning and looked on the ground, and no rope, no paper, and teeth marks all throughout the soap. So Otis enjoyed your soap very much.
Oh my gosh, you know, actually that is something we hear a lot, that dogs do like the soap. Sometimes they'll eat it, and
he definitely ate it.
I mean, you should. If that ever happens, you should always call your vet. But it's pretty much, the soap is all natural, so it should be a problem. You might have a bubble machine coming out the other end, but.
Well, it probably wouldn't be the first or the last time that'll happen.
that's true. Why, we can't wait to see Otis again.
I know. For Christmas, I'm a huge dog lover, and Otis got to go on your farm, and I talked to Farmer John about Under running through the goats and stuff, and he said that Under likes to eat goat poop, and Otis got to meet some of the goats and stuff and poke a spot, and I was so excited. But I'm making, for all my friends who are dog lovers, organic dog shampoo, and I read somewhere that you can cut up old jeans and just tie them in knots, and they're like perfect dog toys. So I made a bunch of those for my friends, and I'm making organic dog shampoo and putting it in mason jars, and it's going to be a dog lover's Christmas.
Oh, I love that idea about the jeans, because Andra's at that stage right now where she just tears up everything, so I don't want to keep buying all these expensive toys.
Well, yeah, if you're getting rid of any jeans, just rip them up and tie them in knots, and oh my God, Otis loves it. It's like a rope toy, and he loves it.
That's great, yeah, they can tear them right apart, and there's no chemicals or anything in them.
Yep, it's perfect.
That is awesome. Well, thank you for that.
Yeah, you're welcome.
All right. Okay. Well, I'm gonna answer some questions here online.
Okay. Well, have a good day.
You have a good day. Keep watching. There's gonna be some fun people coming in.
Okay. I'll keep watching.
All right. Bye.
Bye.
All right. Let's see. Let's see. There was a question here. Hey, Brent. Everybody wants to know how Brent gets his checks and his guns. We don't need to make his head any bigger than it is. He's got nice arms. He's got a nice chest. You know what? He does exercises every morning. He does this routine of sit-ups and push-ups and twists and turns. And I don't know. He does it for like an hour every morning while I'm trying to sleep. And so that's how he gets his pecs and guns. See, are there any others? How many orders have you guys received so far? The last count I remember before I was nodding off was 220. You know what? I don't know. And the guy, the woman that was here last night that takes orders on the computer, she's gone home. She'll be back, or so her replacement will be back. When they come back, I'll have an answer for you. That's pretty good. Who else is out there? Oh, on cue. Hey there.
Good morning, Joshua. How are you?
Good. Who's this?
This is Amy Wexler.
Oh, hey, Amy.
Hey, I got cut off last night when your Google thing made the exchange, so.
Yeah, I know. It surprised us when Google ran out. Google ran out of space for us, apparently. Well, they're a tiny little startup company, so it's understandable.
Well, how are you doing this morning? Are you hanging in there?
I am. I look all right, don't I?
Hey, you look fantastic. Better than I would.
I snuck away. I took a 2-hour nap.
Oh, you did?
I did. I took
good for you.
I went up to Megan's house. I didn't even drive all the way home. I just went to Megan's house and collapsed on the couch.
You know, people think if they drive into the village that, you know, you come over the horizon and there's the mansion. And it's like, nope, it's down the road a poke.
It is. Yeah, it's down the road a poke. That's exactly right. It's about 5 miles down the road. And now that it's minus 10 degrees, you know, it's just even sitting in the car for those 5 miles, I could have frozen to death driving.
Now, in the summer, can you guys ride your bikes, or is it too dangerous on that highway down there?
That's a good question. We haven't ridden our bikes all the way to work. The roads are very hilly and very small, and we're usually in a hurry because I'm late for work. But so we haven't ridden them all the way to work, but we do ride them on Route 10 there. So
in the back of my mind, whenever I head down into the village, that hill,
yeah,
I take myself back to being 15 and want to be on a skateboard, and then I think, oh, you just really want to die again, don't you?
Exactly. You just want to tempt fate. Well, Ryan, Ryan came down the hill on one of those board thingies. Not a skateboard. It was some, like, stand-up board.
Like a windboard kind of thing?
I don't know what the kids do. So what are you doing
anyway,
today?
I asked for my birthday's in about 3 days now. I asked my husband for a Beekman cuff, and I hope he delivers.
Oh, I don't know. Is his last name Wexler too, or is it different?
It is.
It is. I don't know. I haven't seen all the orders coming through in the last few days.
Oh,
so I can't tell you whether or not.
It's a secret, but it was like the first thing that I asked for this year. I'm like, I don't care.
Well, I would
take it back to California to visit, and one of those.
Oh, that's fine. Yeah, no, I would spill the beans if I saw the order, but I haven't seen anything yet.
You would.
I would.
Not a problem. I'm waiting for this holiday to just start. I'm one of those people where it's like, okay, your birthday is Christmas, and one of those holidays that you just want to snip by.
That's true. What's your daughter doing today?
Well, she's going to school, but she's probably coming home early because we're going to get about 9 inches of snow here where we are. I don't know about you guys, but it's going to get real heavy around 3 o'clock, what I heard.
Oh, really? Gosh, no. I haven't, I've been here, so I haven't looked at the weather. If anybody in Sharon Springs is watching, give me a call and let me know what the weather is. And anybody in Sharon Springs that is coming through Stewart's, I'd love a cup of tea with honey. My throat's sore, Amy.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I wish I was there. I'd bring you one.
I know. Well, maybe somebody's out there. Maybe somebody's hitting the road. Don't make a special trip, but if you're going by Stewart, you come by here. I'll take a tea and I'll pay you double for it. I don't even need the honey. I got the honey here.
Poor baby.
All right. Well, Amy, you have a good day, and check back
in later.
All right. See you later.
Bye, Josh. Have a great day. Love you guys. Bye.
You too. Bye. All righty. Let's see. Are there any other questions out here? Okay. I wonder who's going to come by today. Oh. So we've got... Oh, howdy from Bob in West Hollywood. I remember you, Bob. We met at the cheese shop and then at Williams-Sonoma. That's right. Please tell everyone how wonderful the fruitcake is. Okay, take it from Bob. Take it from Fuzzy Bob 1963. You just gave away your age, Bob. The fruitcake, he says the fruitcake is wonderful. I know the fruitcake is wonderful. Let me get a fruitcake that I can hold up. Is that a fruitcake? Here's the fruitcake. If you've known us for a couple of years, you already know about this fruitcake, the generous fruitcake. This was one of our first holiday products from one of our first years doing holiday stuff, and it's unlike any fruitcake you're ever gonna have. It's made in a historic sense. It uses real dried fruit that's macerated in real applejack brandy. I should have some right now. And it's baked in cake. It has none of those green and red candy thingies. It's real dried fruit in real cake. And it's not overly spicy. It's not like sugary, molasses-y, clovey. You know, it has just enough spice. So it's really like a nice cake with dried fruit and nuts and brandy in it. It's amazing. And so I don't know if you followed us, you know that Good Housekeeping said it was the only fruitcake that they tasted last year that they endorsed. Huffington Post, Martha Stewart, AOL Food. This is probably has the best reviews of any fruitcake anywhere, which admittedly is not a high bar, but this gets the most incredible review. And let me see how, I don't know how many are left on the shelf. I shouldn't be selling it so hard. How many are there, Brent?
We probably have 20 left.
Brent's saying there's about 20, 21 left on the shelf. That's it. We don't make it anymore. That's all. So if you want the fruitcake, now. Call now. Oh, don't call now. Go online. Order now. shop.beekman1802.com. This might be the last chance for the fruitcake. And Fuzzy Bob 1963 is making me tell you about it. Okay, let's see who's on the phone now. Oh, I missed it. I missed that call. Call back if you're watching. All right, who else is here? Who is online? Good morning from Long Island. Can you hold up a star? Thanks, Kathy. Oh, that's a good question. Do we have stars left for him? I can hold one up. I just want to make sure we have it before I sell it. Okay, I'll pull the one out from in front to show. Hang on a second. So this was Kathleen, right? Okay, Kathleen, you wanted us to hold up one of the stars. So this is our anatomy of a star ornament. I'm not sure how many we made this year, but these are handmade. This is a new artisan for us. What's the artisan's name, Brent?
Stephen Drucker.
Stephen Drucker, where's he from? Okay. So Stephen Drucker, he lives about 50 miles away. He makes these incredible glass sculptures. So what he does is he puts like a dollop of glass, and then he teases out the individual strands. So we call this anatomy of a star. It's all organic. The way that the shape is, he pulls everything out by hand, and you see that there's white opaque that forms sort of the main branches, and then there are clear tiny ones that form the secondary branches. And I'm telling you, it is stunning. Gosh, you know, we didn't even bring one home for our own tree. We have to get one. But they're gorgeous. There's only a couple left of these. They're packed and shipped super duper well. So if you want something really special for your tree, this is our special ornament this year. We only do one unique ornament a year, and this is it. So you got to get this, shop.beekman1802.com. All right, Irvine, California. Maybe this is Charo. Hello. I'm doing good. Who's this? Is this Charo?
No, this is Pam O'Neill.
Well, you know what? I'm happier that it's you than Charo.
Oh, you poor baby.
How are you doing?
Well, I fell asleep watching you, and then my tape was breaking up all night, so I can barely see what's going on.
Oh, well, we're back now. Yeah, the every 4 hours we have to start a new feed.
Oh my God! I'm in Colesville and I'm snowed in. I can't get out my driveway. I'd have brought you some cappuccino.
Oh, wait, where are you? You're in Colesville?
Colesville, up by Binghamton.
Oh yeah. You got a lot of snow that way this week, didn't you?
Yeah, I've been to your store before, and I met Brent before.
Oh, we haven't met?
Yeah, I've come into your store and I bought a bunch of stuff.
Oh, thank you. What did you get anything for Christmas for anybody this year?
I've been making stuff at home here.
Oh, I love that. That's
I'm going to be getting your cheese when things slow down, you know?
Oh, that's great. Yeah, I love handmade stuff.
I love your cheese and your soaps and all that stuff. I love your store. And I did kind of what you did. I came from California, and I bought a farm over the phone.
Oh, you did?
And I've been in restoration since 08, so I've been like you, you know.
What kind of farm?
A blueberry.
Oh, a blueberry farm. Yeah, I do. We have met. Haven't we met?
Pardon?
You and I haven't we met? Because I remember a blueberry farmer.
Yeah, and I'm a chef, and I make truffles and edible gold cakes. I'm on your little thing.
Yeah.
I do adore you boys, and I'm so pleased for your success.
Well, thank you. I hope everything's going well your way.
Yeah, I'll bring you some of my blueberry heirloom blueberry jam.
Oh my God, I would love it. Yeah,
I've been making marshmallows for 3 weeks and sending them out.
Marshmallows are a great gift, and people think they're magical when you make them. You know, but
I've been making non-corn syrup because of the GMOs.
Yes. How are you making them?
All I did was take out the corn syrup.
Oh, really? And it's still working fine for you?
It's working great. I'll come up and show you how to do it.
I would love it. Oh, I want a blueberry marshmallow.
Well, yes, but you know what? The peppermint and the vanilla are fine, you know.
Yeah.
And I've been making, you would like this, I've been making miniature gingerbread houses that fit on a coffee cup.
Oh, you're kidding. Oh, you have to post a picture on Facebook. I would love to see that.
It is. Well, it's on my Facebook, but I don't know how to post on yours.
Huh. What if you do?
I think I better bring them over, come up and.
I think that's a better idea, too.
So you get a coffee cup full of marshmallows with a little gingerbread house on it.
That is the cutest thing ever. Oh my gosh, if you are ever coming by, I want to see one.
All you need to do is hand cut from the scraps, you know, and make the front and the backs and the tops. Just use the first cut as your template for the next one.
Oh, I see.
So you just make your little square and then make your little, you know, your triangle at the top and then carefully make two doors, one for the front template and one for the back. So the two doors, when they're glued together with white chocolate.
Okay. Oh, yum.
You always glue your gingerbread houses with white chocolate.
That's a great idea, because royal icing doesn't always hold.
No, it doesn't. You make you crazy. You need eight marines to hold them.
That's a good idea. White chocolate to hold together your gingerbread. And
always, yes.
And that works on any size gingerbread house, you think?
Any size, yes. I had a company, and I made gingerbread kits in the 90s, and we put white chocolate in there, and people would melt it in the microwave, and they were big. I've made thousands of gingerbread houses, and always with white chocolate.
Oh, you know, one year if we commission you, would you make a gingerbread house of the Beekman?
Of course, but I will. I don't need to be commissioned. I could do a gold one.
That would be great. We'd love that. Would be fun for a holiday centerpiece?
Oh, sure. I like to make gingerbread houses you can really eat. I mean, I think.
Yeah.
But couldn't you see all these miniature gingerbread houses that hang on a tree?
I think that's amazing. Oh, I have to see them.
All you do is poke holes in the two roof lines and run a ribbon through it.
You poke holes before you bake?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just take a skewer and make a hole, you know.
Yeah, it doesn't close up while you're baking?
Nope. Just like the gingerbread man. If you went to my website, Pam O'Neill, it's the one with the gold cake. I'm one of your friends.
Yeah.
You'll see all my stuff.
Well, let everybody, tell everybody what it is. Pam O'Neill, is that O-N?
E-I-L-L.
E-I-L-L. So Pam O'Neill.
Pam O'Neill. Like O'Neill, the playwright, you know.
Yeah.
Okay, now, my picture is a gold cake with a white rib, you know.
Oh, yeah, I'll look it up. I don't have Facebook in front of me, but I will look it up tonight.
When you go there, I have another group called Holiday Dilemmas and Ideas. You know, when I saw Josh, when I came in there, I told him about my sugar plum. My dad's recipe is over 90 years old.
Oh, wow.
And you all put one in heirloom, which is great. I've got all your books. I love you. I'm a chef and I play. I'm old. You know, I'm old, so.
Well, you don't sound old. You're only as old as you feel. When I feel really old.
I mean, you guys are children. You know, I've got children your age.
Yeah. Sometimes I feel like I have children
on the dark farm, Brent.
All right, I'm going to take another call. Thank you so much for a call, and I hope to see you with a gingerbread.
Did somebody bring you anything to eat yet?
I know, but this is Sharon Springs, so I know somebody's on the way.
Oh, God bless you, my darling.
All right. Have a great day.
And don't forget to, I'm on your Facebook page, so.
Okay. Well, yeah, I will look. Have a great day, hon.
Bye-bye.
All right, bye. Okay, I have to go blow my nose. I will be right back. I'm eating one of Rosemary's cookies from last night. I think there's two left. Hi, how are you?
Hi, is this Josh?
It is, who's this?
This is Monica. I'm calling you from Michigan.
Oh my gosh, you Michigan people get up early. You're like the third person to call.
I have been up since probably 4:30.
No, I've been up since 4:30 yesterday. How
are you this morning?
I'm doing good. What are you doing this morning?
Oh, I'm getting ready to get ready for work. I don't really want to go. I'd rather stay home and watch you.
Oh.
But
Well, where do you work?
I'm getting ready to have roasted potato and garlic soup for breakfast because I made that the other day to try to kick this virus out of me, and it's working.
Oh, great.
So thank you so much for that.
Yeah, people, if people want to check out the recipe, it's a new lazy recipe. Everybody knows that I make the laziest recipes ever. And I made it last week. I still have the sniffles, so I can't say it's 100% cure. But it's a roasted garlic and potato soup. And the reason it's lazy is because you only mess up one pan. You roast the potatoes, and you roast the garlic, and roast the onions on a cookie sheet in the oven first with a couple of strips of bacon laid over it. So one pan, you put all that on one pan, put it in the oven, you roast it in the oven for, you know, half an hour until everything's nice and brown, the bacon's nice and crisp. Then you take the bacon off, and you put everything else in the blender or food processor, the potatoes, the roasted potatoes, the roasted onions, the roasted garlic, put it all in the food processor in batches so you don't overload the machine. And then you add stock to it, chicken stock. You could add milk too, or if you don't want dairy, just put a chicken stock and puree it. And that roasted onion and the roasted garlic, it tastes so great, but it's also terrific for colds and flus. And then, of course, once
it's
you make
wonderful.
Yeah, then once you make it, of course, you put the bacon over back top of it. So you liked it.
I did. I've had this virus for about 12 weeks, and I just can't shake it. And this is actually kind of opening things up, and I can breathe again. So,
you know what?
Wonderful.
Seriously, make it every couple of days now, and put a little hot pepper in, too. Put the hot pepper flakes on.
Oh, I put red pepper flakes in it.
Yeah.
My son stole my bacon, though. He stole my bacon for his hamburger.
I know.
That's okay.
It's tough, you know. Everybody wants the bacon. So.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Well, that's good.
Oh, yeah. I think your next cookbook needs to be an heirloom home remedy book.
that's not a bad idea. I would love to do simple solutions for age-old problems.
Yeah.
There's so many great things. You know, everybody buys all this fancy copper polish and, you know, for their pots and pans. And I think actually Martha taught us this. We just, for our copper, to polish copper, there's nothing better than either half a lemon and salt or ketchup and salt. Just like cheap.
I had just read that about the ketchup. I haven't tried it yet, though.
Oh, it's great. And you just get a big bottle of the cheapest ketchup you can find, you know, so you're not wasteful. And you just squeeze a tiny little bit of ketchup on your copper pot with a teaspoon or so of salt, and you just smush it around with a sponge, and it just, the tarnish just comes right off.
Wow.
That is good.
I will have to try that.
So where did you say you work?
I'm in Michigan. I'm in Jackson, just about 30 miles south of East Lansing.
Oh, I know Jackson.
Your old stomping ground.
You know, I went to school at Michigan State.
Yeah. In fact, you just signed my books for me at Schiller's when you were there just this fall.
Oh, I wish I could see your picture. I totally remember.
Oh, I'm on Facebook. I'm one of Brett's friends on Facebook.
Oh, good. I wish you were nearby so you could bring me some tea.
I know. I just had to go out and move my car for my son so that he could go to work. And it's really, it's not as cold here now. We're up to about 25 degrees.
Oh, that's
But it was cold last night.
That's like summer.
So, yeah, it was zero yesterday, so it's a little warmer.
Yeah, no.
But we're supposed to get freezing rain, too, in a couple days, so that's no fun.
Yeah, I think we're going to wind up getting some snow. Well, we had a little bit of snow yesterday. We're going to have more tomorrow. But that's great. I'm happy to have a white Christmas. And maybe this means it's getting it all out of its system, and it'll be nice by spring.
I hope so. I just keep saying we're one day closer to spring.
You know, what I keep thinking is I like counting down to the shortest day of the year because I hate when there's not sun. So we're almost at the 21st. And then after the 21st, every day is longer.
Yeah, that's what I'm waiting for. I hate this. I'm a summer person, a spring and summer person.
Well, it's coming.
So,
Okay, well, thank you, and have a good day.
You too. Hope you feel better.
Well, thank you. It's going to be a long day, but I think we got some fun people. When you're at work, try to sneak away and watch a little bit.
I will.
All right.
You take care.
You too.
Take
talk.
For
me. I will. Talk to you later.
Thanks.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, I'm checking all the comments here. I don't see that anyone's gotten through to Charo. I wonder if she, I hope she didn't call while I was gone. Hey, Catherine, good morning, Santa Fe, New Mexico. Did we talk last night? Did we talk last night? Anyway, good morning. Hi, Leslie. Hey, what is that? Amish Co? I like that name. Hi, Vanessa from Chesterfield, Virginia. Okay, hang on. Who we got here? 610. Who's this? Hey, it's Josh.
Hey, Josh. It's Nicole again. I was
trying
to see how you're doing.
Hey, Nicole. I'm doing good. Did you get any sleep?
I did. I nodded off for a couple hours. It was right after you were reading the Christmas tree story.
Yeah, I was hoping reading the book would put people to sleep, and then I could go on.
What did you just say?
I was hoping reading the book would put people to sleep so I could go home. How are you doing this morning?
I'm doing pretty good.
What's
the weather is kind of nasty out this morning, so I'm glad I don't work till this afternoon.
Oh, what time do you have to go in?
3 o'clock, so like 2:45.
Oh, yeah, they'll have everything clear.
Yes.
I just noticed it's snowing here, too.
Yeah, it's snowing, raining, mix of icky stuff.
It's interesting. It's snowing here. It's so cold. It's, you know, it's...
Yeah.
It's around zero. Usually it doesn't snow when it's that cold. This could be the apocalypse right now. So anything else planned for today? What are you going to do before you go to work?
Not much. Probably just keep watching you on YouTube and...
Oh my God, I'm so much
get ready for the day.
So much better than the Today Show, right?
What?
I'm so much better than the Today Show, right?
Yes.
Oh God, yeah.
Yes.
I promise you, I will not have one news story about the Kardashians.
All right.
I guess I just.
Great.
Or maybe I'll just make some up.
Even better.
Let's see. I can make up what kind of story? News story about the Kardashians? Kim Kardashian just got accepted to Yale. Did you hear that? Yeah, she's going to Yale to become a neurophysicist. That's breaking Kardashian news. You heard it right here from Beekman.
Yes,
first.
That's a new exclusive. That's a Beekman exclusive.
It is. It's a Beekman exclusive. Kim Kardashian accepted to Yale, going to be a neurophysicist. No one saw that coming. Nobody, not Kanye.
No.
Nobody saw that coming. We're gonna get some paparazzi out there right now. Right out to Yale. All right, who else is up? I want to see some more comments coming through here.
I saw a couple people up early, and then I fell back to sleep, and then I just woke back up not too long ago.
You are not a good sleeper, are you?
No.
I'm telling you, I could sleep forever now. Hey, Brent, what are you doing?
I'm trying to straighten up the store and get it ready to open.
So Brent is now out here in the store. I turned the thing around so you could see him, but now he's straightening everything up so that we're ready to open today. I hope we get lots of customers. Are we opening early? I guess we're open now, aren't we?
Kind of.
Tell Brent I said hi.
Hey, Nicole. Brent says
hi.
Brent says hi. He's straightening everything up. When are you going home, Brent?
I'll probably go freshen up when the next team comes in.
When is that?
They should be here by 10.
Oh, well, you should go home a little bit early. Go home a little bit before that. Please go home. When's Ryan go home?
He'll probably wait until the next team comes in.
You guys don't need to wait.
Yeah, we want to keep the orders going out until...
How many... Hey, Ryan.
He's on the phone, I think.
Oh. I was going to bring Ryan out here and talk to him, but he's on the phone. You still there, Nicole?
Yes, I am.
All right. Well, I want you to have a good day.
Yes, you too.
And, you keep...
and I'll check back in with you guys later.
Okay, check back. We'll see who's going to show up from Sharon Springs and see who's bringing me my tea. I don't see any tea yet.
It's still early. You got some time.
Okay. I'll see you soon.
See ya.
Bye.
Good holiday.
You too. Okay. Let's see. Morning, Josh. Going to put you on the dashboard and start the ice storm commute. Oh, wait, God, don't know. Don't watch me while you're driving in ice. Yay. This is a PC. I don't know how to use it. Okay. Cindy Manor, good morning from Burlington, North Carolina. I placed my order earlier, but you were asleep on the job. I know I was asleep. But we have crew working around the clock. Right now, it's just Brent and Ryan because we're in between shifts. But I think they've got most everything out that can go out. Why is the door shut? Says Swayman. Door shut because Brent, frankly, looks horrible now. No, we shut the door because when they're doing the packing tape, it makes too much noise to talk. KZ100. Wow, who's this? Hello, it's Josh.
Hey, Josh. It's Susan Littlefield. How are you?
Hey, Susan. How are you? Are you calling from the station?
I am. I'm at the radio station right now.
Oh, great. We have our own little radio station right here.
I'm watching you on television.
Are you?
Well, on my computer. You know what I mean.
I know what you mean. Everybody, this is Susan Littlefield. She is an incredible, I don't want to call you a farm journalist, right?
Yep, exactly.
And in Nebraska, and she turned all over the country. And last year, you were one of the top five farm journalists in the country, right?
Yes, I was.
Awesome. And you didn't win, even though you should have.
That's okay. It was a thought that counted, right?
I think it was rigged.
There we go. I'll go with that one.
Oh, no, Susan, we're going to be, this Google chat's going to be terminated in 5 minutes.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. So how's everything going?
It is going well. We're enjoying some very warm weather. It was supposed to be 47 here today.
Really?
Which is absolutely crazy. We're getting ready to start lambing, so I told the girls, I said, if you're going to lamb today or tomorrow when it's going to be warm.
You know, tell me if this is true, Susan. So Farmer John loves the goats that are born early, right at the edge of coldness, because they usually grow healthier and bigger faster than the ones.
Exactly.
So that, you find that true with lambs, too?
Oh, definitely. Those lambs that are born right before a cold snap seem to have a little bit extra, you know, vinegar in their step, shall we say.
That's great. Yeah, John's going to come in later, so you have to watch.
Oh, I definitely will. I don't want to miss that.
When are you going on the air?
I won't go on the air for another half hour again.
And then what's your schedule like? Do you stay on the air like every 5 minutes, 10 minutes? How does it work?
Every half hour.
Every half hour you're on. What is it?
Yep.
Can we get a scoop? Is there any farm journalist scoop this morning that we can share?
Any farm journalism scoops? Give me half a second to think about that one.
Let's see.
Boy.
Any commodity prices or anything that's...
Oh yeah. I mean, we're going to see some lower numbers on the cattle and the hogs today. I do know that much.
Well, why do you think... Why?
Well, because it's towards the end of the year. This is the last full week of trading. Because
okay.
Next week they'll have Wednesday off because of Christmas. And the following Wednesday off is, of course, we kick off the new year. So it's kind of a quieter... light type of trading that we're going to see the rest of this week is, you know, the traders are getting ready for the holidays just like everybody else is.
Oh, that's right. So that means lower prices on cattle and hogs.
Lower prices on the cattle and the hogs. Not, everybody's kind of shopped out. You know, they've got their grocery menus, you know, planned for the next 2 weeks, so there's not going to be as much.
I think that's fascinating. I think that people, you know, so it goes right from the consumer because the consumer's done all their shopping. Right up to the producer, the prices come down.
Yep, exactly. And it's just a cyclical thing. It should pick up again, you know, when we hit the new year. And we have some pressure, too, coming from China. That's affecting our grain prices today as well.
Oh, wait, what's coming in from China?
So just some pressure from them on purchasing.
Oh, pricing pressure.
Yep. So right now, for you guys, it's a good time to go out there and make some grain purchases for the new year.
Oh, I'll tell John.
Tell Farmer John. He's got to, you know, if he's going to buy some corn, probably a good time to get it done.
Well, the things we can teach on this Beekman channel.
No kidding.
We've gone from made-up Kardashian stories to an explanation of pig and cattle prices.
There you go. That word made up.
No, those ones aren't made up. Well, basically any Kardashian story is made up, so.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Well, I think I'm going to start a new stream before this one cancels. If you get another break, will you call back later, Susan?
I will call back later. You can give me a shout as well, but from all of us, we wanted to wish you guys a very Merry Christmas, and the kids said you've got a really cool sweater on today.
Thanks. My mom made it.
Well, it's gorgeous.
Oh, thank you very much.
All right. We'll chat soon. Merry Christmas.
Okay. Talk later, Susan. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay, everybody. I'm gonna kill this feed, and we're going to start a new one. Check on our Facebook page to get the new link. It'll be up in 5 minutes. We just Google cancels us out every 4 hours, so we have to start a new feed. So go to our Facebook page. I'll have the new link in 5 minutes.